This week, we saw President Museveni flagging off the start of oil drilling in Western Uganda. We also saw the NRM celebrating 37 years in power. What does this mean for regular Ugandans, you and I? You're welcome to this week's edition of the Business Roundup. And joining me is Paul Busharizi, a business editor with The New Vision. I am Vaila Ksasia. Let's dive in. So Paul, welcome to this set, and thank you so much for making time once again to be with us. So let's start off with the cuts that were proposed on the SAGE fund, that's money for the elderly persons in this country. What does this mean? And also Parliament is trying to push to make sure the money stays. The number of people reached are still the same, and also the money actually increases to 30,000 from 25. What does this mean for regular Ugandans?
First of all, I support the provision of some stipend to elderly people, especially those who are out of income. As a social safety net, I think countries should not leave anyone behind. And elderly people who probably have retired or are incapable of economic activity should be helped. So I agree with that, the concept. I think the challenge for the government is that they don't have the resources to do it as well as they wish. I think they're trying to, they start with a pilot and then they're trying to scale it up given the resources. I think the challenge also for government is I'm aware that there are donors who are willing to help with this endeavor, but government is reluctant. It sees it as a way of increasing dependency, which they don't want to do.
All right, so let's now talk about the roads in the city, which have always, you know, needed to be worked on. We have gaping, you know, potholes. We have gaping trenches. We also have, you know, a lot of dust in the city. And there was a discussion in Parliament about why the roads have not been, you know, worked on, especially after borrowing money from the African Development Bank, an equivalent of 1 trillion, to give the roads a facelift. So what's happening, and what can you tell us as Ugandans who are paying taxes?
What I'm aware of is that the roads are due to kick off. Groundbreaking is due in, by March, so we're still within time. The loan we're talking about is about a trillion shillings, about $288 million. Provided by the Africa Development Bank to do about 100 kilometers of road around Kampala. I mean, with all due respect to the Lord Mayor, this project was conceptualized and has been in planning since 2016. He was a mayor of Kampala in 2016. The current executive director of KCCA, Dorothy Kisaka, has been only there for the last 2 years or so. So all these things are not done without the sign off by the council, which Lukwago held. So I don't know what he's talking about. He's been privy to all this discussion. About the cost of the road, of course, road construction has changed in Kampala. It's very evident. In our suburbs now, we have roads which are paved. We have roads that have street lighting. If you look at older suburbs, you know, where roads have not yet been rehabilitated, you have no paving, you have open drains, you have no street lighting. All these are a cost, and that adds to the cost of the roads. And a lot of these roads are also dual carriageway, like they intend to do. They intend to do the road from from Port Bell Road, old Port Bell Road, which is something they have to do. I think it's going to be a dual carriageway, so. The cost, I mean, I don't sympathize with Lukwago's sentiments on the issue.
So with the president finally flagging off the oil drilling, a Ugandan like me would be very interested in knowing, do we receive oil tomorrow morning? Are we going to see oil the next month? What are the technicalities involved? And for how long shall we wait before we see the first oil? And what can you say about drilling? Break it down for us, please.
This week, we've started drilling for oil in Chikube in Western Uganda. It's been a very long process. It's almost 100 years since oil was discovered in Uganda. The British were supposed to have found it in 1920. But we only managed to establish commercial levels of oil in 2006. So between 2006 and 2022, we've been setting laws in order and building infrastructure. and that kind of thing. But still, that's just drilling. We are yet to get oil. Oil is expected in 2025. And this was the drilling that was launched was by Sinopec, which is a Chinese arm. The French Total still has to start drilling. So it's kind of technical, but just I think a sense of the distance they have to drill 3,600 meters into the ground tells you how difficult it's going to be and why it takes so long.
And finally, so the NRM did celebrate the 37 years, you know, in power, and Ugandans had mixed emotions. Some of them saw success, a successful journey, and others saw, you know, a country that is still, you know, struggling with so much. So you as a person, a business editor, what can you say about the NRM's involvement in business in Uganda, making the environment easy for us or difficult? Do we still have a long journey ahead, or have we come a long way and we should really celebrate?
No, of course, there's still more to be done. We're still a poor country, per capita income of less than $1,000. So there's more to be done. But the one big thing in my mind that the NRM has done over the last 37 years that's been good for this country and economy is to liberalize the economy. Essentially, in a previous time, all the companies were owned by the state. You had everything, even from supermarkets to, you know, fishing companies. And with all the inefficiencies that came with it, by liberalizing, essentially, privatizing and letting the private sector come into it, we have better service delivery and all that kind of business. And this has helped the economy grow over the last few years. Imagine a time when it would take you a few months to get a phone line. I mean, now you walk into a shop and you come out with your phone line. I mean, it's inconceivable for some people to believe that you take, you know, a few weeks to get a phone line, but it happens. Now, that's just an example. Where they might have struggled, and where they have struggled over the last 37 years is in regulating this liberalization so that we don't have situations of monopoly or stuff like that. That's where they've struggled, regulating these industries. And I think in the next, who knows, 37 years, we might get that right.
All right. Thank you very much, Paul, for making time. Once again, we shall see you the next week with another roundup. And to you, dear viewer, thank you very much for also making time. This is what we had for you this week on the Business Roundup. For now, let's go back to the news. We'll see you next time.